Everybody, this is Sophie Williams. Make her welcome. And thanks for joining us. In fact, Sophie, why don't you play something for us as a way to introduce yourself to the class?
I'd like to begin by asking you to give me a little bit of a sense of the plot of Breathe In, if you will.
It's about a young woman who comes to stay in the home of a music teacher. And it's about sort of the reawakening.
I thought you said a yoga woman.
Yeah, a yoga woman who becomes in love with his yoga teacher. Yeah, let's change the movie to that. It's essentially about the reawakening of an older man who realizes things in his life that he wasn't able to do, and sort of dealing with those feelings and emotions, essentially.
Okay, what was it that inspired you to make the film?
Working with Felicity again. We had such an incredible experience, and time sort of pushing each other and trying to be the best versions of ourselves that we could be. So really kind of wanted to keep going and keep exploring in that sense.
And Felicity, was that your inspiration for joining the cast of Breathe In, working with Drake again, or was it not actually a big deal for you?
No, absolutely. We had such a great time with the first film that it felt really natural to come together again. And I loved the treatment. I loved the character in the story, so wanted to come back.
That was the idea too, is to sort of essentially do a much darker and much more mysterious character. Anna is so open and so vulnerable and so emotional, and Sophie's sort of the opposite. She's repressing almost everything that's going on in her life. And it was really fun to sort of watch the darker version of her, essentially.
It's safe to say that your piano skills have improved.
They have, somewhat. I worked with an amazing coach who I couldn't have done the film without, and she is a concert pianist herself, so there were a lot of intense piano lessons, and I'd actually done it once before in a film, so I had the very basics, and so it was trying to be as convincing as possible, and obviously she did the much more sort of complicated pieces, but I just wanted to try and do as much as I could myself.
And Drake, tell me about the very classical mood to Breathe In.
Yeah, I wanted it to feel very classical in that sense. I think the movie that really inspired it tonally was a movie called The Place in the Sun, starring Monty Clift and Elizabeth Taylor, I believe in the 50s. And it's just a very sort of simple, classical sense, like you said. And something very beautiful and romantic blossoms inside this very dangerous context, and that was, sort of the structure for what we wanted to do.
You missed my class. Any reason for that?
I'm not going to be taking the class, so...
You're not going to take the class? Why not?
I've just been thinking about it, and I just don't think it's going to be the right thing for me to do.
You just changed your mind. Okay, well, look, you still need to come until your name's taken off the roster. We have to talk to Mr. Deakins and get it arranged. We have to get your name taken off, and we have to...
I spoke to Mr. Deakins this morning, and I made sure that it was okay.
So, the film's been very well received. Have you had any personal feedback? People come up to you saying, I thought the film's all right, actually.
I find the film really polarizing, which is exciting. I mean, I feel like with the last movie, people, either... didn't really like it, but, or they loved it. Whereas this movie, people that don't like really, really hate it, and they find they're really upset by it, and that's kind of exciting.
That's great.
As well.
Yeah.
Or people really love it and it really touches them. So I think this movie is very polarizing, which is really exciting, and it really cuts to the emotional core of the audience, I think.
Well, that's good, because it means hopefully it's unsettling people in some way, and that they feel
very much so
challenged by it.
No.